Hello, everyone. Today we're going over a cultural subject that is a lot to get into, honestly. The Greek gods of Olympus. For the sake of keeping this video short, or shorter than it could be, we're going over a basic who's who of the Olympian gods. If you want to know more on this subject, such as the more obscure myths about each of them, let me know and I'll make a video on those. Anyway, before we get started, I'm going to drink some tea of the gods. What's that? Well, let's say you want to sharpen your brain power for a bit, then maybe try the Athena cherry and coconut green tea for some herbs that'll help you out with that. They've got all sorts of creative teas that match up with the Greek gods to help you out, plus little learning descriptions on each of the gods, so that's always fun. Anyway, if you'd like to join me in drinking some tea this video, go to the link in the description and use the coupon code SAM for 11% off on your order. The Olympians, basically referred to as 12, although there have been 14 sort of counted, came into power after they defeated the previous universe rulers, the Titans, who lived on Mount Olympus, with the exception of Hades, if you're counting him as an Olympian, he lived in the underworld. Individually, they have all different powers and reside over different things, so ancient Greeks had plenty of gods to choose from for their worship. Thought I'd start with Zeus, king of the gods? No, he cheated on Hera a bunch. Let's put him last and jumble up the order a bit. We'll start with Hestia, goddess of the hearth. She was one of the six original Olympians, and believe it or not, she was actually the first. The firstborn of Cronos and Rhea, king and queen of the Titans. She was quite pure and peaceful. She wasn't in many myths due to her staying home and tending the hearth so much. She took a vow of chastity when both Apollo and Poseidon wanted to marry her, since choosing one might have caused turmoil in Olympus. Selfless, isn't she? Hestia is later sort of replaced among the 12 Olympians by Dionysus, god of wine. His upbringing was pretty wild. He's a son of Zeus and Semele, a princess of Thebes. The jealous Hera, Zeus's wife, persuaded Semele to tell Zeus to prove his divinity by appearing as his full-fledged divine self in front of her. Doesn't sound like a good idea, does it? It didn't work out. So, at the time, she was pregnant with Dionysus, so Zeus took the baby, sewed him into his leg, and somehow Dionysus was born later? Yeah. He did grow up to be the god of wine and the god of ecstasy, which meant he was in a lot of art and literature. Hades, as he's the god of the underworld, he typically dwells there. As his name became synonymous with the place where people go after death, ancient Greeks hardly said his name. When they referred to him, they called him Pluton, meaning wealth giver, as precious stones were found in the ground. Besides being the oldest son of Cronos, the most famous myth he's involved in is the abduction of Persephone, Demeter's daughter. As Hades loved her and she ate fruit from the underworld that wouldn't let her leave permanently, a compromise was made to where Persephone would spend part of the year in the underworld with Hades and the rest of the year with Demeter. Hence the creation of the seasons, winter and spring. To make the season creation part more clear, Demeter is the goddess of agriculture, so her grief of Persephone being in the underworld causes winter. She doesn't have many myths to herself, though, mostly being tied to the myth of Persephone's abduction. She's the second daughter of Cronos and Rhea, and tends to be largely associated with grain and the harvest. Let's move on to the god of fire and blacksmiths, Hephaestus. He's basically like the god of engineering, so I don't get why he's not viewed as cooler. It's possibly because of his looks. When he was born, his own mother, Hera, hated how he looked and threw him from Olympus, crippling him. He later got his revenge when he gifted Hera a throne that tied her in place. The other Olympians tried to get him to let her go in exchange for a spot among the Olympians, but he only let her go after Dionysus got him drunk. Later, he was married to Aphrodite, goddess of beauty and love, but she kept cheating on him with Ares. Speaking of Aphrodite, she's the goddess of love, beauty, and fertility. She was created from the sea foam remains of Uranus, the father of the Titan Cronos. She represented the perfect female body for the ancient Greeks, being a symmetrically perfect maiden. She was married to Hephaestus, the ugliest of the gods, to calm the jealousy of all the gods attracted to her. But she ended up cheating on him anyway with virtually every Olympian except the goddesses Hades and Zeus. Her most famous consort, though, was the god of war, Ares. Let's talk about this dude. He was the god of war, but not its strategic parts, merely its destruction, violence, and brutality. As a result, virtually no one but Aphrodite loved him. Apparently not even the Greeks liked him much. He He's a son of Zeus and Hera, and depending on how you view Hephaestus, as merely Hera's son or both Zeus's and Hera's, Ares may be the only son of Zeus and Hera. Athena, on the other hand, was the goddess of the strategic parts of war, plus wisdom, peace, and crafts such as spinning and weaving. As a result, virtually everyone respected and admired her. She was born out of Zeus's head, literally, due to him swallowing her mother, and then Hephaestus cut open his head with an axe because he got a headache. From Athena. Yes, that story is interesting. This virgin goddess has several myths associated with her, such as her weaving competition with Arachne, and her competition against Poseidon to become the patron of Athens. Many know Poseidon is the god of the sea, but he was also the god of the earth, causer of earthquakes, and creator of horses. He's the second son of Cronos, the king of the Titans. He's been known to be very ill-tempered, hence the storms in the sea. He also challenged Zeus along with Hera and Athena, and fought against the Trojans in the Trojan War because they didn't pay for a wall he built. His wife was Amphitrite, a Nereid who didn't want to marry him at first until Delphinus the dolphin convinced her. Speaking of wives, let's introduce the goddess of marriage, the queen of Olympus and the wife of Zeus, Hera. She watched over women, children, and families in general, but when Zeus would cheat on her, she became vengeful against Zeus's consorts. She couldn't touch Zeus, though, because she swore she never would after she initially tried rebelling against him with Poseidon and Athena. Yet he had no problem with making sure no one had ever touched Hera by severely punishing those who tried. If you're looking for a god who covers a whole lot of things, look to Olympus's messenger, Hermes. He's a trickster, the god of roads, flocks, thieves, and commerce. He's the son of Zeus and Maia, the oldest of the seven Pleiades sisters. The day he was born, he stole Apollo's cattle and invented the lyre, an instrument. Apollo was furious when he found out about the cattle, but forgave Hermes in return for the lyre. He can also cross between the land of the living and the land of the dead, giving him the title, the Leader of Souls. The reason Apollo loved the lyre so much is because he's the god of music, but like Hermes, he covers a few different things as well, including medicine, health, archery, poetry, prophecy, and the sun. Like Aphrodite was for the female body, Apollo represented the perfect male body for the ancient Greeks. His father was Zeus, and his mother was Leto, who couldn't give birth to Apollo and his twin Artemis anywhere on Earth, except for the floating island Delos. Artemis literally came out of the womb as the boss. She helped her mother give birth to Apollo right after Artemis was born. She's the virgin goddess of the hunt, moon, chastity, and nature. She, like her brother Apollo, was very protective of her mother. When Niobe, a mother, boasted of her children in comparison to Leto's children, Apollo and Artemis shot down all 12 of Niobe's kids. Alright, we have to discuss this one. He's the most famous. Zeus, king of the gods, lord of the sky and thunder, ruler of justice. He's the youngest son of Cronos and Rhea, and the one who was hidden by Rhea until he grew up to make Cronos regurgitate his five brothers and sisters. Zeus's five brothers and sisters, not Cronos's. Anyway, then he started a giant war of gods against Titans. Then when the gods won, Zeus was made king and he cheated on Hera a ton of times. Yeah, he had 26 children, three or four of which were with Hera. Anyway, I'll at least give him credit for freeing his siblings. And those are the primary gods of Olympus from Greek mythology. Thank you for taking some time to learn some culture history. If you'd like to see some more science, art, and math videos, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe. And check out my website, Steam for Sam, or use the code SAM to get 11% off some good... good and godly. I meant to say godly, but you know what I mean. Good and godly tea. See you next time.